Special guest, Shannon Noll. Thanks for joining us on our uneventful little day here on Studio 10.
It's pretty crazy, isn't it? Wow.
Yeah.
It's all happening.
Look, I know you've been doing a lot of work for the drought, which is, you know, really the issue that Australia should be concentrating on the most at this point in time, not the egos and career desires of various people in Canberra. So tell us where that's at and you know, what you've seen.
Oh, it's terrible. Absolutely terrible. I've spent a lot of time back at home and travelled around a lot, and crops, we should have crops this high coming out of the ground now, you know, this time of year, and it's just bare. And the scariest part about it is because obviously we're going to have a fail crop this year, there'll be no hay for next year. We're already desperately low on hay stocks around the country now. I think Victoria's finished. There's only a little bit in West Australia and some in Tasmania. So we're under real pressure now, and if it gets any worse, because the biggest thing you've got to understand with this too, if we get some rain now, it's 3 months before any feed will grow, and we need backup rain. A lot of people make the mistake of going, oh, it's raining, the drought's broken, but that couldn't be further from the truth.
That's right. It's got to be the right type of rain as well. You don't want a big downpour that washes away.
That's right, yeah. And then a bit of backup and then a little bit more rain, a little bit more rain after that would be great, you know. Yeah.
Now, I've got to ask, you were in the news a bit yourself with an incident with a can of beer. tell us a bit about what happened there.
Very unfortunate. It wasn't just one. We were there for 80 minutes and I nearly got hit with a can before I even started to sing. And there was 30-odd cans thrown on stage during the set. I watched the band members get hit. The people in the front row were getting hit in the back of the head by cans that weren't making the stage, and they were full as well, so hitting the stage and just exploding. I had fed up with it by the end, and I asked them to stop four or five times. The security guards were just totally overwhelmed. There was only... They had 4,000 people there last year and there's 9 or something this year, so... They were completely overwhelmed. And then, I didn't see it coming because I was trying to do a good job of dancing around, trying to duck and dive, and then I didn't see one coming and I literally missed my eyelid by about that much, a full can. And heat at the moment, said some things I really regret.
Can I say, back you 100%. I think those pigs in the audience should be taken out the back and get the bloody bejesus talked out of them. Obviously, there was a bit of blue language that we won't endorse, but, you know, it's bloody outrageous that you were hung out to dry for something that some other thug did.
Because that, to me, because that has happened to me on... I used to do an act, this is a long time ago, and we're a cabaret act, four women dressed as men. And sometimes people were so pissed, they thought we were men. And anyway, we had cans of beer thrown at us. And it's such a... You simply don't know what to do. And so in that circumstance, what were you thinking? Well, you've got cans coming at you, you've got people in the audience being hurt. And did you feel angry that you were the one who caught the kind of shellacking from the general public?
I mean, 100%, yes, but I brought that on myself with taking it too far. But the biggest thing with it was is we should have walked off, but I knew the event would suffer if we did. It's a small country town in the middle of a drought, and there's more people in that town at that moment, more cars they've ever seen in town. So if we walked off, then people would want refunds, would have ruined the event. Nilland could have ripped the place apart because it was loose as
Doc Neeson was once famously sent to hospital when he got hit in the head by a full can of beer at a concert down at Sydney Opera House. It can be dangerous, but we do have to get you to make a very hefty donation into the swear jar for the drought.
That's the one thing, if I was a politician, I wouldn't mince my words anyway. That's for sure.
That's right. Noll's here for PM.
Hang on a sec. There have been whispers that you might think of one day being a politician.
I don't think so. I think that ship sailed.
on the plus side, all your skeletons are well and truly out of the closet.
That's right.
There's nothing left to dig up.
That's exactly
right. Well, in the words of the Blues Brothers, maybe the solution is chicken wire. But there we go.